Hi guys, today I thought I would jump on and film a quick makeup tutorial. The sun has been out all week and I was feeling something a little bit more vibrant, and I've just been very kindly given this Makeup Revolution palette, which is in collaboration with Soph. It has got 24 shades in there and I absolutely love how it's got like a really big variety of colours. You've got 12 matte colours and 12 with a shimmer going through it. I love that it has like the golds, the neutral kind of tones, but also you've got pops of colour in there, which I think would look really nice for spring. You've also got brow shade, transition shade, and a black. I love it when a shadow palette has a black eyeshadow in there because you can also smoke out all the looks. It's got a really big mirror, so really good if you're traveling. I'm also trying for the first time today Morphe brushes. So there is 15 eyeshadow brushes in this box. The brushes retailed at about £41 because I used code James for 10% off, and the eyeshadow palette retailed at £10. So really good affordable products that I'm using in this video. The brushes, they feel really, really soft. There's a mixture of synthetic and natural hair going through these brushes. Some of them are really fluffy, great for like going through the crease, but also you've got these smaller brushes which will be really nice for like detailed work. Like, I love this brush. These two look really, really nice. You've got one for brows, you've got one for liner. So that you literally have got 15 brushes and I think these are gonna be amazing. So I'm gonna get stuck straight into the video. If you want to see how I created this eye look, then please keep watching. Okay, so first up, I'm just going to take this Morphe M330 brush. It's like a nice, real fluffy brush. And I think I am going to start off with a transition shade. So I'm going to dip into these two colours here because I want it kind of like warm in the crease, but I don't want it as orange as this one. So I think these two here would be like a nice transition shade to use. And I always start on the outer edge of my eye because obviously this is where you want most of the colour to be. So you don't want to go straight into the inner corner because otherwise you're going to pack too much colour in this area where you want it to diffuse nicely in. So I always just start on this outer edge and just start blending it through. This is actually the first time I'm using this palette on myself. So I used it on a teen lesson last week and I was really impressed with the pigment. I thought the colours were really nice and the pigments like were really high colour as well. So I'm just blending this eyeshadow back and forth and then I'm just using what's left on the brush to bring it up a little bit higher so it fades out into a nice diffused kind of eyeshadow look. I've just put a little bit more on the brush and I'm just going in on the outer corners a little bit heavier just to build up that pigment. And I've just added a little bit more on the brush and I'm just focusing the colour a little bit more on this outer edge where I want the colour to be a little bit more intense because I'm going to make it a little bit more smoky on the edges. So far, this colour is really, really nice. The pigment is there. And it's really easy to blend as well. Like, I've not had to work hard at blending it in. It's not gone patchy. Yeah, it looks really good so far. So next up, I'm just gonna dip into this slightly darker, warm, like terracotta kind of color, because I think this would be nice just to smoke out the edges a little bit. I'm using the Morphe M506 brush. So this brush is a little bit smaller. So I absolutely love smaller brushes to sort of start blending out that smoky kind of colors with. I'm just starting on the outer edge of my eye. I'm just blending this lower down, like more on the mobile lid. And I'm kind of stopping halfway with this. And I'm blending up into my crease, but I'm just not going quite as high as I went with the transition shade, because you don't want it too dark, too high. So the whole point in the transition shade is that it gives all the colours something else to blend into. So it's like that in-between colour. So the first colour will always go quite high and then the darker colours will sit lower down on the eye. And then that way you get that nice, like, soft blend. I am just going to switch brushes and just go back in with some of that transition shade because it was looking a little bit blocky. So I just want to soften up those edges. on my eye shape, because I've got quite a hooded eye, I like to kind of wing the eyeshadow out a little bit so you can see the colours more when my eyes are open. So that's a little tip if you've got hooded eyes. You can always bring the shadow up a little bit higher. I'm quite lucky because I've got quite a big space here, so I can bring the eyeshadow up quite high. But my lid space is really small. Like you see, if I look straight on, I've only got the tiniest little bit of lid space. So that's why I always bring my eyeshadow colours up quite high. As long as you're leaving a little bit of a gap for the highlighter or like the brow bone colour. So I am getting a little bit of fallout with these eyeshadows, but that's fine because usually I could do my eyes first if I do feel like they drop down. But I feel like if you just tap the excess of the shadow off the brush, then you'll probably find that you don't get as much fallout. But because I'm not doing that, that's why it's dropping down, because my brush is like fully loaded of product. So yeah, I'm really happy with those colors so far, and the brushes are amazing. So next I'm just gonna dip into this color here, so it's like a really nice shimmery purple, and I'm using a slightly flatter brush. In this brush set, they didn't actually have many flat brushes at all, and this is one of the only flat brushes they had, but that's fine because I feel like the blending brushes for me are more important, and I could use this anyway. I know it's quite small, but I could use this just to like blend on the lid. So I'm gonna pack this on, and this is going right on the actual lid of my eye. Wow, look at that color, it's gorgeous. And this one's got more shimmer to it, so it's gonna have a lovely, like, shimmery sheen. It doesn't really have a glitter, which I love, because I don't actually really like eyeshadows with a lot of glitter to them. But this has just got that lovely shimmer to it. So I'm just packing and packing it on, building up all that colour, so you can really see that pop of purple. You can see that I just need to blend like this bit here because there's a bit of a harsh line. So I'm just going to switch my brushes. And I'm going to go down to that small blending brush that I used the second time. And I am just going to blend this harsh line out. And just remember to like always go back into your transition shade, because you probably will need to build that back up in through the crease. Because I feel like sometimes when you're blending everything, you start blending everything too much sometimes. So you do need to sort of go back in with the other colours just to build that intensity up a little bit. And then what I'm going to do next is I'm just going to dip into this lovely matte black, but I'm taking an even smaller brush. So this is the E36, and I am going to tap off the excess this time. And I'm going to just work this in to the very, very outer corner of my eye. And I start off low down because obviously you want the colour to be darker and more intense on the lash line. So I'm just packing it in there. And then I will start lifting it up a little bit and just blending it into those other colours. That is actually a really pigmented black. Like, for this palette, it's only £10. So the colours are actually really pigmented for such a cheap palette. So I'm just switching back to that other brush, and I am just going to start diffusing this all out so you just get that nice fade. I actually feel like I want the purple to stand out a little bit more, so I think I'm going to just spray the brush and just go in with that purple again. So I've just wet the brush a little bit with a bit of setting spray. And I'm just going to pack this on because I just feel like I want that purple to stand out a little bit more. And by wetting the brush, the colours will always look more intense. It just looks a little bit more like foily when it's wet, which I love. But the technique I'm using now is just still patting it on, because you really want the colour to be most intense on the lid. So I feel like by packing it on, you really get that full, like, bam of colour. And I've gone back into that terracotta shade, and I'm just using this just to diffuse the purple and the black in together, because you don't want it to look like a line and then it just stops in the middle. You want these to have a nice fade as well. And because I've got a hooded eye, I do just bring even the darker colours up just slightly. You can kind of see where my fold is. And then I just actually even bring in the darker colours up just a smidge higher than that, because my eye is getting droopier by the year. And I'm switching back into my transition shade just once more, just to give it a tidy up and to blend out all those edges. So what I'm going to do now is just add a bit of highlighter. So I think I'm going to go for this colour here, because the white one is a matte and I'm not a massive fan on matte colours for highlighting, because it doesn't really reflect the light that well. So I think I'm just going to take a little bit of this colour. Maybe you could mix the two together as well, just to brighten it up a little bit. And I'm just going to add this with a smaller blending brush. And always make sure you're using a clean blending brush when you're adding your highlighter, because you don't want any of the old colours coming through, especially if you've been using black. And I'm just taking this on the brow bone just to give that bit of highlight. And I'm going to take it on the inner corner as well, because this always opens up your eyes a bit more. Well, look at that sheen. That's actually a really pretty highlighter. I hope it's picking up in the camera, but it is blinding. So what I'm going to do is just quickly go on the other eye and just do the same on the other side. Okay, so now I've just finished on the other eye, I'm just going to take the purple and the really small brush that I used and just run this right underneath my eye. So I'm just tucking it under the lashes and bringing it all the way from the inner corner to the outer corner. And that'll just give that nice pop of colour underneath your eyes as well. I find especially when you've got hooded eyes, it's nice to bring the colour underneath, because it really does open up your eyes more. And I'm just going to take the smaller blending brush again. It was the M506. Take it into that corally kind of colour. And I am just going to use this to blend out the purple a little bit and just give a nice, like, softer blend underneath. I think as soon as spring comes, you want to start bringing out those like brighter colours and be a little bit more daring and a bit more colourful. So I think these colours in this palette are perfect for that. I'm just going to use the Morphe M432. It's a really flat brush, really, really dense and perfect for adding detail or smoking out the lash line. So I'm just going to pack the black on to the lash line and just bring it all the way across, and I'm just stamping it on. Because I've got hooded eyes, I don't want to add too much eyeliner, because it just takes up too much of my lid space. And then it makes my eyelids look even smaller. So I'm just stamping this in, and this will just make the lashes look a little bit thicker. And when I put the false lashes on, it will just help blend the false lashes into my natural lash as well. And I find if you add a black into a colourful eyeshadow look, it kind of makes it look a bit more wearable. So if you're scared of wearing like pops of colour and really bright colour, if you put black into it and it makes it more smoky, I feel like that anyone could wear, you know, a smoky pop of colour and it doesn't look too crazy. So with the E36 brush, I'm just going to blend the black out a little bit so it doesn't just look like a line underneath my eyes. These Morphe brushes are actually super soft. I think some are synthetic and some are natural hair, but they've all been really, really soft so far, and they blended amazingly. Okay, so I don't think I'm going to go for black in the waterline today. I think I'm just going to use a white Kohl pencil. This is just an Avon pencil. And I'm just going to run that into the waterline. So now I've done my eye makeup, I'm going to go in with some false lashes. These are the Prima lashes, which is one of my favourite brands of lashes to use. There's so much selection with Prima, that's why I love them. These ones I have used them before, that's why they're out of the box, they look like this. These are in the style called Vein. They're quite fluffy and really, really long, so nice if you want a really glam look. You guys will have to let me know if you want to see a video on how I apply my false lashes, because it is definitely tricky. I find it is something you find easier over time. I really do love Prima lashes. I find there is such a nice selection, and also they're really affordable lashes as well. Usually I go for like the shorter ones, but I felt like trying something a bit more glam, and these are really big and really fluffy. You can see how fluffy these lashes are. They're absolutely gorgeous, but they do smaller styles as well. So if these aren't for you, then that's fine. They do have smaller, shorter lashes, all different styles, thick, thin, individual, you name it, they've got it. I'm just gonna quickly go off the camera now and just do the bottom mascara, and I'm just going to finish off my skin and my lip. So I just popped off the camera and put a little bit of highlighter on, a little bit of blusher as well, and also just finished it off with this lip, which I think this nudie kind of lip colour really complements the eyes really nicely. Final thoughts on the palette. I think it was incredible for £10. I mean, it blended really, really well. The pigment was there. I didn't really have to build it up a lot, which I thought was really good. I also love the fact that there's lots of colours in there, so you could create loads of different eyeshadow looks with this. I love the fact that there's mattes and shimmers, so you can create a lot of dimension on the eye. So, you know, really nice, whether you want it natural, whether you want it a little bit more dramatic, there's something in there for everybody. Brushes, I absolutely love the Morphe brushes. I think they were really soft, really easy to work with, and I love the fact that there's smaller brushes in there so you can add lots of detail into the eyes. Please let me know what you think of this video. Leave a little comment below for me, and don't forget to subscribe, and I shall see you in the next one. I'm talking to you, see you standing over there with your body, feeling like I wanna rock with your body, and we don't gotta think about nothing. I'm coming at you, 'cause I know you got a bad reputation. Doesn't matter, 'cause you give me temptation, and we don't gotta think about nothing. So I'm just waiting for my lashes to dry now. I have used the duo glue with the lashes, because I just find it's the best one. Gluo, that actually sounded like a really good name for a glue. Can I copyright that name?